Russia suspected of developing anti-satellite capability by the United States. White House National Security Spokesperson John Kirby says the weapon is concerning but poses no immediate threat. Kirby adds U.S. President Joe Biden has directed a series of initial actions in response, including additional briefings to congressional leaders and direct engagement with Russia.
Our general knowledge of Russian pursuit of this kind of capability goes back many, many months, if not a few years. But only in recent weeks now has the intelligence community been able to assess with a higher sense of confidence exactly how Russia continues to pursue it. It would be space-based, and it would be a violation of the Outer Space Treaty, to which more than 130 countries have signed up to, including Russia.
On Wednesday, Republican lawmaker Mike Turner had warned of the new Russian weapon, which he has called a serious national security threat. Israeli forces confirm a raid on the biggest functioning hospital in Gaza. Despite the chaos shown in videos, the Israeli military describes the raid on the Al-Nasser hospital as precise and limited, saying it was based on credible information that Hamas militants were hiding in the facility and had kept hostages or the bodies of hostages there. Hamas denies Israel's claims. Health authorities in Gaza, meanwhile, say the raid forced out displaced Palestinians and families of medical staff sheltering in the facility. Israel's air and ground offensive in Gaza in response to the October 7 rampage of Hamas has so far killed more than 28,600 Palestinians. A deal on the release of hostages held by Hamas still possible. With the very hard issues that remain to be unsolved, U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken says an earlier response from Hamas on a potential deal includes some clear non-starters, but offered the possibility of working toward an agreement. Israel believes more than 100 hostages remain in Gaza, with 29 believed to be dead.
We believe it must be and must remain a priority to do everything we can to bring the hostages home, to get them back with their loved ones. And that's where our focus is. We've done a lot of work to try to get back to this point. That is where we think an agreement is possible, even if difficult. And for, at least from the perspective of the United States, we think it's imperative that we continue to pursue that urgently.
Talks involving intelligence chiefs from the U.S., Egypt, Israel, and Qatar on a deal that would see a pause in the months-old war ended without a breakthrough Tuesday. In New York, where the first-ever criminal trial of a former U.S. president has been set, Judge Juan Merchan junking an appeal from Donald Trump to dismiss his indictment in his hush money case. Merchan instead scheduled a March 25 trial for Trump, which could jeopardize both his campaign and his freedom. Trump had asked the judge to toss his 34-count indictment with charges of falsifying business records to cover up a $130,000 payment to adult film actress Stormy Daniels before the 2016 elections. Trump has pleaded not guilty to the charges.
This country, it's a disgrace. It's all a rigged, it's a rigged state, it's a rigged city, it's a shame. What they ought to do is go out and take care of the violent crime and the migrant crime that's destroying people and killing people. Not a case that everybody says, you take a look at the legal documents and the legal scholars writing about this. They say there's no crime. This is no crime. But outside, right outside their courthouse, this courthouse, people are being murdered. So it's a very unfair situation.
The ruling in New York ensures Trump will stand trial in at least one of the four criminal cases against him as he pursues a likely rematch with U.S. President Joe Biden in the race for the White House. Trump's legal battle in Georgia also facing a crucial test. Fannie Willis, the prosecutor overseeing his election interference case in the state, pushing back on claims that her relationship with a colleague presented a financial conflict of interest. Trump's team claims Willis financially benefited from her relationship with fellow prosecutor Nathan Wade. But the district attorney calls the accusations lies. Wade was hired by Willis to help lead the prosecution in Trump's election subversion case. Trump is seeking to get the entire case dismissed, with his lawyers arguing Willis should be disqualified from the prosecution due to her relationship with Wade. The latest now on the deadly shooting in the Super Bowl victory parade in Kansas City. Police ruling out terrorism as a motive, saying the incident was due to a personal dispute. The number of victims meanwhile rose to 23, while their ages ranging from 8 to 47. Death toll remained at 1. 3 people are in custody.
First and foremost, I want to stress that preliminary investigative findings have shown there was no nexus to terrorism or homegrown violent extremism. This appeared to be a dispute between several people that ended in gunfire.
I do think that there is a gun violence challenge in this community and many others, and there certainly is a gun violence challenge as it relates to major events. That, however, does not mean that Kansas City will stop having major events. We will do all we can to make sure people are safe.
The Kansas City shooting marks the latest high-profile outburst of gun violence in the U.S. It also took place on the 6th anniversary of the Parkland High School shooting in Florida, which left 17 dead. Well, let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news making headlines for Filipinos in North America. A historic night for Filipinos in Southern Nevada. The NBA G League Ignite hosted its Filipino Heritage Night for the first time at the Dollar Loan Center.
The Filipino community is such a huge part of Vegas, and we want to make sure that we're connecting that basketball community with some of its biggest fans in town.
This is honestly just amazing to see the Filipinos out here tonight supporting the Ignite and the rest of the fans supporting the Filipino community.
Fans were also treated to an array of Filipino dishes, as well as a special jersey designed by Phil-Am designers. Phil-Am rapper Easy Mill entertained the crowd at halftime.
Being able to do this in an official court for the NBA is it's pretty dope.
The Indiana Mad Ants won over G League Ignite with a score of 116-109.
We all solved the riddle.
And finally, in entertainment news, while busy leading his own show, Quantum Leap, Raymond Lee says if Tom Cruise calls to have him play a more prominent role in the recently announced Top Gun Maverick sequel, he'll be ready to fly in a heartbeat. Right before booking the lead in Quantum Leap, Lee had a minor role in Top Gun Maverick together with fellow Asian cast members, Filipino actor Manny Jacinto and Cara Wang. Unfortunately, they didn't have much screen time in that movie. The actor admits his social media post about the Top Gun sequel is a playful nudge to its producers to cast the film's Asian cast as the co-leads this time around.
I'm definitely not against that. I definitely put that up, wishing that some folks involved on that creative side would be thinking in that direction. You know, Top Gun Maverick was a perfect movie, but what could have made it even more perfect is if they included us a little bit more in it.
This is the butterfly effect to end all butterfly effects.
Quantum Leap airs on NBC and streams on Peacock. And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.